Hello, everyone. Today, I want to give you a quick overview of a few features that are included in the Power Apps Portal's 2020 Release Wave 1. Key investment areas for this release are focusing on simplifying portal management, and they include Power BI integration, so you can quickly add Power BI reports, tables, and dashboards to your portals without coding. Themes that you can use to align your portal to your organization's branding. An identity provider configuration wizard that walks you through the configuration process. Global search that now includes searching inside custom entities. And finally, the ability to identify and configure your portals from within the Power Platform Administration Center. Let's see how this works. You've been able to take any Power BI report, chart, or dashboard and place it in the portal, and then make it accessible to anyone, whether they're external or internal. But you had to do it in the code editor. With this release, we're enabling that experience right within the Portal Design Studio. So let's embed a Power BI dashboard into a portal and make it available to our organization. You used to have to edit the code here, and it would have taken hours. Now, from the Components menu, we have the Power BI option, which enables a Power BI component on the portal. You see the properties on the right. And we see a message that we still need to go to the Portal Admin Center and enable Power BI Embed Service. Here we have two options: to enable Power BI visualizations for the organization, which we've already done, and to enable Power BI Embed Service for the organization. But because we're only going to add the visualization, we don't need to enable the Power BI Embed Service. Now, Power BI comes in three flavors. The classic Power BI for your customers, which you can enable in any website. Embed for your organization, which is what you see as a user of PowerBI.com. And you can also do a publish to the web. Well, we'll select Embed for your organization. And you notice that the properties panel changes. Select the workplace, type of component. Well, we'll select Human Resources Dashboard. And we have the option to select all or just some of the tiles on that dashboard. We'll select all. And new to this release, the preview pane immediately refreshes and we see the full dashboard. To see what this looks like for our users, we select Browse Website, and here's our Power BI dashboard on our website without having to edit code. One of the main asks that we've received is to be able to apply organizational branding to portals without coding. With this release, we're introducing themes to make that possible. To do this, you start by enabling basic themes, and you see a bunch of options. Now, the preset themes are ready to use, so we can change from blue to gray, to dark blue, and finally orange. Now, to modify one of these presets, click on the ellipses and select Customize. And a copy of the orange theme appears in the Custom Theme section. And you can use the right menu to edit the theme, like the text color of the header. And as soon as I make the change, we get a warning that the contrast ratio is too low for accessibility standards. So not only do we support themes customization to match your branding, but we also help you create compliant portals. Another area we've simplified is the setup of authentication providers. This is required for any portal that's not anonymous. We'll start in the detail view of your Power Apps portal, and here you see the type, language, URL, etc. of your portal. And in this new section, we have the details on your identity providers. We'll select See All for a list of identity providers that can be configured in the portal from this simplified option. This list will grow, and for providers not yet on the list, you can still configure them from the Portal Management app. So let's set up the Microsoft OAuth option. These are your Outlook.com and Live.com accounts. Select Click to configure, and all of the items that you'll need are here in the one list. The redirect URL, and if you've set up Microsoft before, you'll already have a client ID and secret from your identity provider. And once you've set a provider, you can always go back to edit the settings. The Azure ADB2C setup is a little more complicated than OAuth, but we've also made that a step-by-step process. We've been talking about how to simplify the maker experience, but we've also been asked to be able to search custom entities. Well, we're enabling that in this release. Here's a typical search, where you can adjust where you're searching and the dates. In this case, we have custom entities called orders and order products. So if we search for an order, we see that we have a bunch of orders that start with 090. But in this case, we know that our order includes Northwind, so we'll search for both. And we get back a list. And you can see that some are from the order products custom entity, and some are from orders. So we'll dive into one of the order products. You can configure what page opens up when someone selects this result. In this case, it's a pre-configured page where we're showing products that shows all of the orders for this product. And all of this is from configuration. None of this was from coding. Another update with this release is the ability to see all the portals present in a tenant from the Power Platform Admin Center. You can see details on the portal status, environment, created on date, and type. In this case, we have a trial portal. So if we select it and click on Manage, we go to the Portal Admin Center for that portal. Another option from the Portal Admin Center is to select environments. And from here, under Resources, you can see the portals connected to this environment. We think that this ability to identify and configure your portals from the Power Platform Admin Center will be extremely helpful. As you've seen, the 2020 Release Wave 1 update to Power Apps Portals provides you with simplified portal management, including Power BI integration, so you can quickly add Power BI reports, tables, and dashboards to your portals without coding. Themes that you can use to align your portal to your organization's branding. Identity Provider Configuration Wizard that walks you through the configuration process. Global Search that now includes searching inside custom entities. And finally, the ability to identify and configure your portals from the Power Platform Admin Center. For more information, use these specific links or go to the Release Overview Guide.